沙漠开江河。选择 Making Choices， 作者黄江河 Alan Wong。 人一生都在选择怎样过他的日子，从日常的衣着打扮，到读哪一间大学、名校，哪一门专业，毕业后容易找到工作，而且又高薪的，娶一位美丽又贤惠的妻子，生儿育女，开名车，住豪宅。若选择能如此完美的话，那是最理想不过了。人生还有其他什么要求的呢？可是，生命的过程并不是我们想象中一般如此美好。比方说，大地震发生时，你正好在一间大厦的中心，而你又没有足够的时间逃命。在那一刻，你没有选择的权利，你只能听天由命，没有别的路可走。又比方说，2004年12月26日，印度洋大地震时，你刚好在泰国度假，发生海啸，是很强的地震引发的，造成很多人员伤亡。根据统计，至少有22万人罹难，而你当时根本无法选择，只有听天由命。希望灾难不要临到你。人性的本能都向往好的一面，而避开不幸的遭遇。可是很多时候事与愿违，我想大多数人都有这个经历。我们求的都是好的，最好是一帆风顺，财源滚滚广进。我们人的本性就是如此。而当我们受苦时，就怨天尤人，怪老天爷不公平。真的，平时我们不敬畏他，有事时就要他负责。你说，我们人是否很可恶呢？今天世界上的人口已超过70亿，每个人都是为了活而生，唯有一个人，他是为了死而降生在我们中间，这个人就是主耶稣。正如先知以赛亚在公元前732年所预言的，以赛亚书53章2到8节说：“他在耶和华面前生长如嫩芽，像根出于干地，他无家形美容。”我们看见他的时候，也无美貌使我们羡慕他。他被藐视，被人厌弃，多受痛苦，常经忧患。他被藐视，好像被人掩面不看的一样，我们也不尊重他。他诚然担当我们的忧患，背负我们的痛苦，我们却以为他受责罚，被神击打苦待了。哪知他为我们的过犯受害，为我们的罪孽压伤。因他受的刑罚，我们得平安；因他受的鞭伤，我们得医治。我们都如羊走迷，个人偏行己路。耶和华使我们众人的罪孽都归在他身上。他被欺压，在受苦的时候却不开口。他像羊羔被牵到宰杀之地，又像羊在剪毛的人手下无声，他也是这样不开口。因受欺压和审判，他被夺去。至于他同室的人，谁想他受鞭打，从活人之地被剪除，是因我百姓的罪过呢？哎，写到这里，心中感到亏缺了主的荣耀。基督徒时常把爱这个字挂在嘴边，时常说 要爱人如己，可是谁能行出来呢？最吊诡的是，当初主耶稣行神迹奇事的时候，被人追捧，受人爱戴，可是最后却被出卖、唾弃、被钉十字架，完全得不到人的爱，天父也掩面不看他，因我们所有人的罪孽都归在他身上。照着天父的计划，耶稣必须死在十字架上，这是天父差派主耶稣降生世上唯一的目的。若主耶稣不死，我们世人没有一个人能逃脱上帝的刑罚。然而天父却舍弃他的独生爱子主耶稣，甘心情愿代替我们的罪而死，使我们与上帝和好。因为主耶稣的宝血洗净了我们一切的不义，所以我们必须信他。亲爱的朋友，若你还没相信主耶稣，此刻是应该打开你的心灵的眼睛，接受主耶稣基督为你个人的救主，因他在2000年前为你舍命，流尽宝血，死在十字架上，3天后复活，赐给我们永生的盼望。就好像约翰福音12章24节告诉我们的，我实实在在地告诉你们，一粒麦子不落在地里死了，仍旧是一粒，若是死了，就结出许多子粒来。总结，天父选择了一条我们世人绝不会走的道路，舍弃他的独生爱子，代替我们的罪死，而主耶稣也选择顺服天父的旨意，走上十字架的道路，替我们死在十字架上。试问，我们能活出这种爱吗？愿上帝赐福于你，阿们。 Making choices. Man has to make choices all his life, from what to wear every day, to which university and profession to get into, so later you can easily land a job with a high salary, have a beautiful and nice wife, have children,and buy a luxury car and a mansion, so on and so forth. It would be the most ideal if we could make all perfect choices. What else can we ask for? But life is not always what we expect. For example, when a big earthquake occurs, you are in a tall building and you do not have time to escape.At that moment, you have no right to choose. You can only accept the fate. There's no other way. Let's also assume that you happen to be on vacation in Thailand on December 26, 2004. A tsunami caused by a big Indian Ocean earthquake came. According to statistics, at least 220,000 people were killed.You had no choice at that time, but resigned to fate, hoping the disaster would not come to you. Human beings by nature wish for good fortune and avoid the bad one. But oftentimes, things go against our will, and I'm sure most people have experienced so. We wish for a life of smooth sailing, wealth and health.This is human nature. When we suffer, we blame God and others and accuse God of being unfair. Really, we don't revere God, but when something happens, we blame Him. Do you think that we are so abominable? The population of the world today exceeds 7 billion. Everyone is born to live, but there's only one person.Who was born to die for us. He is our Lord Jesus. As the prophet Isaiah prophesied in 732 BC, in Isaiah 53:2-8, He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away. Yet who of his generation protested? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people he was punished. Oh, as I am writing now, I feel how badly I fall short of the Lord's glory. Christians often say the slogan, "Love your neighbors as yourself." But who can actually do it? A paradoxical thing is that huge crowds praised and followed Jesus when he performed miracles, but betrayed and despised and crucified him in the end. No love could be found anywhere. Heavenly Father hid his face from him because of our sins. According to our Heavenly Father's plan, Jesus must die on the cross. This is the sole purpose of the Father sending Jesus to the world. If the Lord Jesus had not died, none of us could be spared from the penalty of God. Our Heavenly Father abandoned his only beloved Son, and the Lord Jesus was willing to die for our sins and reconcile us with God. Because the blood of the Lord Jesus has cleansed us from all unrighteousness, we must believe in him. My dear friends, if you haven't believed in the Lord Jesus, you should open your spiritual eyes and accept him as your personal Savior. 2,000 years ago, Jesus died for you on the cross and was resurrected 3 days later, giving us the hope of eternal life. John 12:24 tells us, "Very truly I tell you, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds." To sum up, Heavenly Father chose a path human beings would never take, to abandon his only begotten and beloved Son to die for our sins. And the Lord Jesus obeyed Father's will and took the path to the cross. May I ask, can we live out this kind of love? May God bless you. Amen.